بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. Once again, I thank Allah Azza wa Jal foremost to have helped us gather today another time. I would like to apologize again for me coming late. There was a bit of traffic. And I would like to thank the brothers, the organizers, for having invited me today. And I would like to thank you all for attending today. As you all know, Allah Azza wa Jal, from His great wisdom, He has favored some nation over others, and He has favored some prophets, some people over others. As Allah Azza wa Jal has favored Islam over other religion, and He has favored our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam over other messengers. قال الله تعالى تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض منهم من كلم الله. Allah Azza wa Jal said many of the Quran that there are some prophet who are better than others, and also from His great wisdom and mercy, He has favored some places over others, as He has favored Mecca and Medina, and Baytul Aqsa, or He has favored Baytul Aqsa, which is Masjid al-Aqsa, over other masajid and over other places. And as well, Allah Azza wa Jal, from His great wisdom, He has favored some time over others. And as you all know, we are living now in one of those months in which Allah Azza wa Jal has favored over other months. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, Inna iddat ash-shuhuri inda Allahi 12 shahra fi kitabillahi yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal-arda minha arba'atun hurum fala tadhlimu fihinna anfusakum. Which means Inna iddat ash-shuhuri, and the number of months in the year since Allah Azza wa Jal created heaven and the earth, there are 12, in which 4 of them are holy, sacred. They are haram. Minha arba'atun hurum. فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Do not transgress. Do not sin in those months. And in a hadith, in a narration, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has clarified what the 4 months are. He said, in many narrations, one of them he said, ذُو الْقِعْدَى ذُو الْحِجَّةِ and Muharram, consecutive, mutataliya, which means consecutive months. And 1, Rajab, that is between Sha'ban and between Jumad al-Thaniya. So these months are the month in which Allah Azza wa Jal has made holy. And the scholars, they had they had opinion in about why Allah Azza wa Jal had made those months holy and sacred. And it is from the mercy of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal wanted people to, because before Islam, Hajj existed. Hajj was always in all religion, and in all religion of Tawheed since Ibrahim alayhi salam, the people, they used to perform Hajj in Mecca. And in order for the pilgrim to go in safety and everything, Allah Azza wa Jal has decreed that there will be no fight during this month. Why the month before of Dhul Hijjah, the Dhul Qa'dah? Because normally at the time, it takes them 1 month to travel to Mecca. So the month of Dhul Qa'dah, they are not allowed to fight. And the month of Dhul Hijjah, we all know, because these 2 weeks where pilgrimage is performed. And the month of Muharram, it is because when the people normally go back to their families and home. That is why Allah Azza wa Jalla has made them holy, so that people can move freely and people can use the transport freely and with safety. As for the in regard to Shahrul Muharram, in regard to Shahru al Muharram, why is it called al Muharram? Why is it called Shahrul Muharram? There are many opinions, and there are many saying of the scholars. The best of them is the one of Ibn Kathir. He said that Allah Azza wa Jal, He called it al Muharram, which means sacred, in emphasize. Why? Because at the time of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Arab before Islam, they used to, 1 year over other, every other year, they used to make Muharram haram, a sacred month, and then the following year, they used to make it halal for their own purpose, for their own, interest. And then So on, they used to make it 1 year haram, 1 year halal, 1 year haram, 1 year halal. And they used to make the month following Muharram, which is Rajab, haram. But Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed, and He said, this is nasi, innama nasi'u ziyadatun fil kufr, yudallu bihi alladhina kafaru liyuhilluhu aaman wa yuharrimunahu aam. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, this is kufr. The fact that you play with the sanctity in which Allah Azza of this month, in which Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed, He made month of Muharram haram, then you don't play around and make it 1 year halal, 1 year haram. That is why scholars say that this month is called Muharram. Muharram means that it is indeed sacred, very, very sacred. There's no hadith, particular hadith or particular verse in regard to this month of Muharram, in regard to the virtue of the month of Muharram as a whole month, such as in the month of Ramadan, such as the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. There's no such hadith about it. However, there are hadith, many hadith, in which Allah Azza wa Jalla, in which the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned that the best fast is the fast of Ramadan. And the best fast after Ramadan, the best fast after Ramadan is the fast that is done during the month of Muharram. This is narrated by Muslim. That is why many scholars say that it is recommended to fast during the month of Muharram. Don't fast the whole month, because Aisha radiallahu anha, she said that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not fast all month, I mean as a whole, except Ramadan. And the month in which he fasted the most is the month of Sha'ban. So if you try to fast every Monday, every Thursday, or the 3 days of the 13, the 14, the 15, which is called the wide days, Ayyamul Bir, then it is recommended to fast. Why? Because the best fasts that are done are the fast done during the month of Muharram. And also there's one day in that month in which our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he determined that whoever fasts that day, he said, I hope that Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive the sins, will expiate the sin of the preceding year, of the year preceding that day. And we know that it is, we all know it is the day of, the 10th day of Muharram, which is called Ashura. And before Islam and before our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he recommended fasting it, and he said it is good to fast. They used to fast it. There are Arab people, they used to fast it before Islam. They used to fast it because Jewish that live in Mecca or they live in Medina, they used to fast it. And when our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he migrated to Medina, he found the Jews fasting that day and venerating that day, I mean respecting that day. And then he asked them, he said, why do you respect that day? Why do you fast that day? They say, because it is a good day. يَوْمٌ صَالِحٌ نَجَّى اللَّهُ فِيهِ مُوسَى مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ. It is a day, it is a good day in which Allah Azza wa Jal has saved Musa from Fir'aun. And here our Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam showing respect to his brother in Tawheed, to his brother in faith, Musa Alayhi Salam. He said, نَحْنُ Muslimun ahaqqu bi Musa minkum. We are more closer and we have more right upon Musa to you Jews. Which means that if this is indeed happened, if indeed that Allah Azza wa Jal has saved Musa in that day, then we should be the first one to fast. Why? As a thank, to show appreciation and to show a thank and a praise to Allah Azza wa Jal that He has indeed saved Musa from Fir'aun, because that day is a great day, and this serves us as a lesson that Allah Azza wa Jal will always give victory to His supporters, to His allies, to the one who calls people to Tawheed, to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. As you all know the story of Musa and Fir'aun, there was no, I mean, comparison. Look at the Jaysh, look at the army of Musa. The army, if we can call it, the followers of Musa, they were all weak. They were all from the low caste. And look at the army of Fir'aun. Musa alayhi salam, he only used the help of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is a lesson for us. A lesson for us that do not despair. Do not give up hope. Do not give up hope. Musa never gave hope. He never gave up. He always He was always relying on Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is also a bushra, this is also a glad tiding that no matter what the Muslims are doing now, no matter how weak they are, no matter how sinful we could be, but al-aqibah, the final result and the final thing will always go to the muttaqin, will always be in favor of the muttaqin, of the pious people, of the one who stand firm upon this religion, upon this tawheed, upon spreading the message of Islam, spreading the message of tawheed. So let's go back to Muharram. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he first came in Medina, he found the Jews fasting this month, this day, afwan. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Musa has more right upon us. We should fast. We should fast as a thank of Allah. We should be fasting more than you Jews, which means that we should be the first one who fast as a thank to Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he commanded, in the beginning of Islam, before Ramadan was prescribed upon Muslim, it was compulsory to fast. It was compulsory to fast the day of Ashura, in the beginning of Islam. And then until Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the ayah of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun." O you who believe, a fasting was prescribed upon you the same way it was prescribed before the nation before you, that so that maybe you might be from the pious people. So when Ramadan was prescribed upon the Muslim, then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "It is good to fast the day of Ashura," and he said that I hope that Allah Azza wa Jal will expiate on that day, will expiate the sin that have preceded that, the sin of in the year that have preceded Ashura. And then they fasted like this until the last year before our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam died, in which Allah Azza wa Jal commanded our Prophet to defer everything that the Jews used to do. Every act of worship, every tradition that the Jews used to do, our Lord has commanded our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to differ from the Jews. So he said, if I was about to live the next year, inshallah, then I will fast the ninth day, Tashua. I will fast the ninth day alongside the tenth day. But Allah Azza wa Jal, he decreed that he did not live on that year. So he never fasted the ninth day. However, it is recommended to fast. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he fasted the ninth day. Why? To differ from the Jews. To be different from the Jews. And scholars, they said, it is also permissible or recommended, if you can't fast the ninth day, to fast the 11th day, to differ from the Jews. There's two opinions from the scholars. Some of the scholars, they say it is indeed recommended and it is indeed legislated, because they are based from a hadith narrated by Imam Ahmed that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, differ from the Jews if you fast Ashura, fast with the day before and the day after. But there's a long, there's a long study and a long research about that hadith, and it turned out that many of the scholars of the hadith, they weaken that hadith. They say that the hadith is weak in narration, therefore it is not to be taken. So it is permissible to say, we can't say don't do it, but if you want to follow the sunnah, if you want to be closer to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, therefore fast the ninth day and the tenth. Is it permissible to only fast the 10th day? Is it sufficient? Naam, it is sufficient. You have not committed a sin by fasting the 10th day. However, it is best to fast the 9th day and the 10th day. First, to differ from the Jews, and secondly, to hope more reward, to have more reward, because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, if I was alive the next year, if I would be alive, or if I will be alive the next year, then I will fast the 9th day. This is what is about what we should do in the month of Muharram. And what we should then do in the month of Muharram is what some of the people who call themselves Muslim, they used to take that day as a day of saddening, as a day of sadness, as the day of, we should grieve. They grieve this day because they say that this is a day in which Hussein ibn Ali radiallahu anhuma, Hussein the companion, the grandchild of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the two masters of the youth of Jannah, he died on that day. He was killed, he was murdered. And they take that day as a day of grieving, as a day of sadness. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, we should not worship Allah. We should not worship Allah with sadness. There's no such thing. You're allowed to be sad if you lost some member of the family. That is fine. But as a worship, we should not take one day or use a day of sadness to get closer to Allah. There's no such thing. When the Prophet Muhammad asked him, he passed away, we shouldn't say, okay, that day we're taking the day of sadness, we should cry and we should slash ourselves because the Prophet Muhammad sallam died. There's no such thing. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not legislate these type of action. So whether our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he died, or Musa alayhi salam, or Ali, or Abu Bakr, or Umar, Allah Azza wa Jalla has never legislated and he has never commanded us to do this type of action. So we should not take this day as a day of grieving and as a day of sadness. Rather, we should take this day as a day of praise and thank to Allah Azza wa Jalla. You should thank Allah Azza wa Jalla by fasting. We should worship Allah Azza wa Jalla by fasting as a sign of appreciation that he has saved Musa from Fir'aun. So such as lashing yourself or lamenting or tearing your clothes as a grief or as a sadness because Hussein radiallahu anhu was killed on that day, there's no such thing. If it was narrated, then why some of his sons who were alive when his father was killed, or some of his grandson who were alive when their grandfather was killed, Hussein, why they did not grieve themselves? Why they did not, lament themselves or slash themselves? They never did that. This shows that this type of action and this type of thing that some of the so-called Muslim do, it is not narrated or it is not legislated in Islam. So I'm going to stop today, inshallah, by saying that may Allah Azza wa Jal help us fast this day, the day of Ashura, and may Allah Azza wa Jal make us that we can fast the month, we may fast the month of Muharram with ikhlas, with sincerity, and may Allah Azza wa Jal make us that we die as a Muslim, as a muttaqeen. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.